Over the past few years, drag queens have been stepping their heels out of the dark late-night cabaret bars and into the mainstream. These days, your local plumber probably has a favourite drag queen. He may even be one.
It's all thanks to the global success of RuPaul's Drag Race, the addictive reality competition that's now giving Kiwi and Aussie drag queens a chance to be crowned the very best. Laura Daniels sat down with the show's judges to learn about the new series, RuPaul's Drag Race Down Under.
Now sis it out, wow.
RuPaul's Drag Race is a global phenomenon with hundreds of episodes and many spin-off seasons around the world. And now, it's here.
Hello, 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 New Zealand. Good day, good day, good day.
We are so lucky to get the original host, the RuPaul.
Let's go.
And 90s pop star and general icon, Michelle Visage. Along with the hilarious Aussie comedian and personal friend, Reese Nicholson.
Reese and Michelle, oh my goodness, kia ora, how you doing?
Ah!
Hey.
Kia ora.
Wow!
Thank you.
Wow!
Thank you.
Have you been working on that?
I've been working on a lot. Like, when I visit other countries, I like to get really assimilated into the cultures.
Reese, you came here all the way from Australia. Has it been a huge culture shock
for you? Huge difference, you know, it's 2 hours ahead of time.
Can you tell the difference between our accents?
Terrible, Muriel.
I've been trying to teach Michelle and Rue where we end a sentence unsure of ourselves.
Like, we're always sounds like a question.
Oh, no. Yeah.
Really nice to meet you.
Right.
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah.
So some Seven Sharp viewers, they may be a little bit unfamiliar with the worldwide phenomenon that is RuPaul's Drag Race. What can they expect from the show?
RuPaul's Drag Race to some may seem like it's just, you know, kids dressing up in frocks and putting makeup on and being outlandish or being political, but it's so much more than that. It's about the tenacity of the human spirit. It's about stick-with-itness and grit and determination and, you know, despite all odds, overcoming.
It's time to wiggle it!
It's the type of show where I don't think anyone in the world could watch an episode and not be like, this is my favourite thing in the entire world. Like, sitting backstage at a stand-up show with, you know, some of the most masculine, blokey guys that I know being like, did you see Sasha over the weekend? She absolutely, you know, she's got to step her up. Like, you know, that's like a... And it's just like this kind of, the culture is starting to drip into the mainstream.
How have you found that New Zealand and Australian drag has compared to what you're used to in the UK and America?
What I love about Drag Down Under is the same cheek that you would find in, say, Europe. And that's how it differs from America. And that's the beauty of drag around the world, is it's regional. So Perth drag is going to be different to Melbourne drag, and Auckland drag is going to be different to Wellington drag. But that's the fun, to see how they hold up against each other. I love seeing drag wherever I go from every part of the world.
Have there been any New Zealand or Australian songs you think would make an amazing lip sync?
Look, I can tease, there are some hardcore Australian bangers that I, in the room, was like, there's going to be blogs about
take
this.
It from him.
Like Waltzing Matilda.
Both our national anthems. That was a tough one.
For anyone watching at home that wants to give drag a go, that are New Zealanders on their small rural farms, what advice would you give them to, like, break their bubble?
I think if anybody wants to try it, you start with some makeup, sit in your mirror. It's not going to be good. And that's okay, because it's about self-expression. Mm-hmm. So you can throw on a red lip, you can throw on some lashes, get a little pussycat wig. You can even put on a dressing gown, put on a robe. Whatever you need to make yourself feel good, and that's how you start. Anybody could do drag.
Amazing.
We're all born naked.
And the rest is drag. Thank you so much for talking to me today.
Thank you.
I am so honoured. And I'll get onto the blower to Jacinda.
Yeah?
And we'll
see
if you guys can stay.
Yeah.
Are you busy? No.
No.
Can I get a passport, please?
Passport. Yeah, I can arrange that.
Thank you.
I'm very good at Photoshop.
Thank you. Not that guy. No, don't get me in trouble.
And you can catch RuPaul's Drag Race Down Under on TVNZ2 on Saturday at 8:30.